bitch. 911, somebody come get this bitch. Nigga, you're a star on the ride, you got time to reply. Don't lie, you can eat my shit. You can give me five little nigga on the side, little nigga, cup of dowdy to fix my whip. I swear, size on the nigga who's down, your nigga, you're fried, just fit my nigga, my whip. You know I never did you wrong. Even though I'm right here by the phone, dog. You know you never used to call. Keep it that way now. I'll treat you like you're dead right now. I'm on your head right now. You wanna fuck with me so bad right now. But now you can't right now. Oh.
2018, I was in my sister's house the whole summer. Songs wasn't doing numbers. Whole life was going under. Left school, then my daddy and I had a face-to-face in Atlanta. He said, it's one me and me and Chance, and I told him, daddy, I ain't never wanna. I ain't never need no nigga. I ain't never need no feature. If I didn't blow, I would've died, you could be here. If it didn't go to the side, I wouldn't be here. Then they all come around and they be here. You get this rich and famous, everybody come up to you singing. Hallelujah, how you doing? You been on my mind, you been running through, yo. You know I never did you wrong. Even though I'm right here by the phone, dog. You know you never used to call. Keep it that way now. I'll treat you like you're dead right now. I'm on your head right now. You wanna fuck with me so bad right now. But now you can't right now. Mama told me she was gonna stop fucking around with that nigga. Tell me she be clean, but I'm knowing that ass is deceiving. My mama told me that she loved me, don't believe her. When she get drunk, she hit me up out with a fever like, oh, you ain't even out that pretty. You ain't even out that nigga. You ain't even out with me, God will forgive you. Shit. You ain't even out that pretty. You ain't even out that nigga. You ain't even out with me, God will forgive you. You know I never did you wrong. Even though I'm right here by the phone, dog. You know you never used to call. Keep it that way now. Treat you like you do right now. I'm on your head right now. You wanna fuck with me so bad right now. But now you can't right now. Oh.
Treat you like you do right now.
What's going on, Conscious Crew? It is your favorite breakdown commentator, CTV. Welcome to another riveting episode of the Consciouztv platform. As promised, here is the HIV result party, okay? Let's hope that everybody has their paperwork in. So you already see what the title gives. Before we get into all things factual, I need you guys to go ahead and thumbs up this video until it is absolutely stuck. You guys know that thumbing up not only helps with YouTube's algorithm, but more importantly, it triggers up the notification system. So when you are thumbing up the video, you are literally knocking on the digital door of another Conscious Crew member and telling them that the king is indeed kanging. Also, shout out to all of the new subbies and all of the hundreds of followers, girl, that I got on Instagram as a result of all of this free for promotion. Mwah! What's up? Last but not least, please have your notification bell set to all and share the stream out to whatever it is you have digital community, whether that be your YouTube community wall, your Snapchat, your BGC, your personal OF. I don't give a damn where you lay the link. Just let them whores know that we're allowed live and in color. With no further ado, let's go ahead and push on through.
I know a place where you can recharge your soul.
Baby, that's Consciouztv.
And in the midst of brokenness, he gon' see your asshole.
Baby, that's Consciouztv.
You gon' heal, you gon' laugh, and catch a little shade.
Ooh, girl.
Y'all know he be slaking, y'all better stop playing. Come hear what he's saying.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Hi everybody, what's going on? So I want to make some statements before I bring up Larry. I know we had a discussion last night as a community about all of the myths that's going on, and I just want to say that I really thank you all for your support and for your love and for your unconditionalness. You guys are 100, and we might not always agree, but I know that everything that you guys say and you guys want for me is out of love. We had a very thorough conversation and dialogue that was really enriching. I feel like the conversation carried in a respectful way. People were able to be honest. Oh, there's a, hold on. Wait, hold on. All right, can you guys hear me now? Is everything okay? Give me a one if the audio sounds okay. Give me a one if the audio sounds okay. I had to unplug my microphone. No? I'm saying two. Okay, hold on. Okay, how does it sound now? Is it still static? If it's still static, give me a one. If it's still static, I'm gonna just have to unplug the mic and use the built-in microphone. Okay, some people saying one, some people saying two. One, okay, everything sounds normal? Everything sounds normal? All right, one, so we're good. Somebody's saying it's worse. Hold on, let me pull up my own feed, girl, because what y'all not about to do is play on my top like this. Hold on, let me run my own shit. Hold on, let me see something. I hear what you guys are hearing. Hold on, let me see something. Let me see something. All right, I'm gonna have to kind of yell then. All right, so can you guys hear this fine? I'm using my built-in microphone. I don't know what's going on with Miss Mikey. Okay, everything sounds okay? It's a little delay in the chat, so let me make sure y'all clear before we... Yes, okay. It's a little delay in the chat. Okay, yeah, that sounds much better. All right. So anyway, girl, welcome you guys. Thank you for being here. I just wanted to make a church announcement super quick. I just want to tell you guys thank you for all of the support, all of the love. You guys have been really amazing, especially under the circumstances. I feel like I've been raised back from the dead, hell. But the support is immense. I know we had a town hall meeting last night to address some of the preliminary stuff leading up to this live stream. And I know we don't always agree, and we didn't agree on everything last night, but I understand that everything that you guys said to me was out of wanting what's best for me and loving me. And so I appreciate the principle behind the energy last night. I also want to also say that there have been people that I don't get along with on these YouTube streets. They don't like me. I don't like them. But I also see that some of them are in the chat and they have put aside their opinions about disagreeing with me and have been able to rally behind me and say, while I don't agree with you all the time, CTV, what's happening is dead ass wrong. So shout out to Trees. Shout out to a lot of you guys who, you guys know, y'all over there, I'm over here. But I see the support and I really appreciate the maturity of it all. So we're going to get into the meat and the potatoes. I'm going to bring up our guest, Dr. Larry Reid, live in the building. Thank you for gracing the platform, Dr. Reid.
Hi, can you hear me?
Loud, live, and in color.
All right, great. I'm ready.
So, obviously, addressing the elephant in the room, for those of you who don't know, there was a live stream that was done apparently on another so-called blogger's platform. And during that IG live, there was a conversation about another individual who is at this point a common enemy between Reid and this blogger. And Dr. Reid had brought my name up in good spirit, and this blogger decided to blurt out that I have it too as it relates to HIV. That sent shockwaves, not really because of the blogger themselves, but because of who that blogger said that in front of. This blogger has spoken ill of me because I ran down factually on them years ago. Those facts can be found in the criminal justice system and in the civil court system. It's not opinion based. It wasn't gossip. It wasn't unsolicited hate. It was justified, and it was justice. So
unsolicited hate.
Sorry, I pulled it up on my phone.
So this individual made those statements. And because they made those statements in front of Dr. Reid did shut it down. And he did let it be known that we're not going to do that. And this is my good friend, and let's not do that. And a lot of you guys felt like Dr. Reid was not, he didn't do enough. And I know why you guys are saying that, and it's because you guys are comparing him to me, and you guys are comparing how you guys know that I get down, not only as it relates to Dr. Reid, but just how I get down in general when it comes to just anybody that I love and anybody who's in my circle and anybody that I have alignment to. I'm very passionate. I'm Scorpio. I'm empathic. And so when it's up, it's up. But not everybody has the same personality type. I understand that under these circumstances, a lot of you guys felt like fuck all that because of the nature of what was said. You guys felt like this wasn't like somebody saying, oh, CTV ain't shit or CTV is irrelevant, but it was a very polarizing, accusational, inflammatory statement. So I know that I'd also revved up y'all's expectation in Dr. Reid, but I don't really want to speak for Dr. Reid. He's here to really speak for himself. Here to speak to what happened there, and then we can get into the receipt party.
Okay. I didn't know that all of this turned into this, but it has, so there it is. Anyone that is familiar with how I move and how I speak on the internet, especially when it comes to these other bloggers and all of the stuff that pops off, I don't ever get down in the dirty like I used 2018, early 2019. I don't do it for myself. I don't do it at all because I'm representing more than YouTube commentary. I'm representing quite a bit that I have to carry. And the only person online that I have consistently over and over and in real life spoke positively concerning and really shared how we have an authentic, true, and real friendship is CTV. So I feel in my heart, which could be different than what you said on the live, because I didn't get to watch the live. I just feel in my heart that whoever hate me, and possibly whoever is envious and jealous, envious and jealous of our online relationship and real life relationship, will find something wrong with what I said. I was a guest on somebody else's platform, and he made a comment about somebody, you, that I am close to. I thought he was talking about somebody else that I didn't want to discuss, but then he said your name. I said, no, I said, using my Consciouztv? He said, yeah. I said, that's my friend. He said, oh, I'm sorry. I said, no, that's my friend. That's right. And then I said, and he don't even, but he kept talking. It's online for everybody to see. And I was going to say he don't even have HIV, because I would think, although it's not my business really, but we've been dealing for so many years, something like that, I feel like you would have told me. I mean, just regular talking. So I felt comfortable enough to say that you did not have it. But if you watch, you can see my mouth move, but he was talking over me because the mic was loud. It was his live. So anybody, and I'm saying this with all of my heart, maybe because I'm grieving and I'm just tired, anybody that felt as though I handled that wrong, for real, fuck you. I mean, to the highest, I don't care if you like me, you like conscious, fuck you. I don't care. And at this point, I'm seriously tired of the internet. 100% tired of the internet. The only person that I am concerned about in this entire exchange, because of the kind of exchange it was, is conscious. I'm not saying I hate William. You know, y'all know me and William been friends for years, but we had a break off. So that, but he's not even the concern in this. It's conscious. And I wished that I just hadn't brought your name up, because I brought it up and positivity, like I always do on other platforms that may not favor the conscious for one reason or the other. I'm gonna always do that. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna forever do that. And I don't.
What do you say to the people who feel like, you know, that he didn't and doesn't care for me because I assisted Pastor Matthews and suing him for defamation successfully, and some people are arguing that you knew what you were doing and saying my name in that space and knew that it wasn't going to render a positive result and feedback from?
I mean, that's their opinion. I mean, I don't even know if that's a real person, because the way the internet works, you got these people who jump around to people's YouTube and they just stir up stuff. I mean, I don't know.
I argued last night that, as you just said, you bring my name up really everywhere. And I felt like that was actually you also being loyal then, because you know what the history is, but you are not going to refute or back down or deny our connection or my contribution to social media just because you're sitting in front of somebody who feels a way.
Yeah. Yeah. It's natural for me to do, and it's also intentional for me to do, especially when I am talking about my journey since 2019, because you were the only one that spoke up, but you were not the only one that could have spoken up. So I'm going to always make that statement, because more people know me than Consciouztv. And there are people who know me before Consciouztv knew me who could have spoken up. They may didn't have the platform he had, but they could have said something in the comment section. They could have went live or something, but they didn't, but Conscious did. So I'm going to always honor conscious for that. And so I'm going to naturally do that when I'm having a conversation about vloggers or people online who was at least questioning what was being said, really seeing whether it was valid or true and researching some things. I'm going to always do that. I don't really care what people say to that. I'm pretty sure more other bloggers care more than me, but I don't really care. That's why I'm saying a huge, fat, juicy, heavy, fuck yeah, I don't care at all. My only thing is conscious. That's it. And I hate that that was said, but that wasn't my platform. He came on my platform, popped up some days later when I discussed in James, and he didn't even closely allude to anything. Cause see, and that's another thing people didn't pay attention to. This was a out of the blue, spare of the moment pop up on his platform. And there was no discussion. Don't discuss this person. Don't discuss this person. That happens when you are about to have a collab. You have them kind of conversation. But that wasn't the case. I just popped up on his thing. And then when he popped up on mine, I guess because I checked him on the one that was on his, there was no problem. I mean, he just done what he does as a commentator. There was no problem, and life went ahead on. Since then, I have had a conversation with him when I saw what was happening. I said, look, if we ever on together, somebody else was saying, he emailed me and said that we're going to be doing some big thing. I said, no, that's not true. I said, but I mentioned to him about doing the people in the chat by the droves that night we were on my platform. Y'all should do something once a month. I said, yeah, that would be a good idea. I mean, when it comes to the church news, me and him is at the top when it comes to influence. I mean, William for years done what he's done, and then I came later. You know, so I don't think that would be a bad thing. But to say that we're working at Larry Live, the brand is Larry Reid. It's going to always be that. Until or unless something happens, it's going to always be that. But I hate that you would then further dragged on the internet. They took that and then made clips and created narratives. I know how that feels. I mean, you've been dragged before, but I don't know if it's been to this level of a health read to say that you have HIV, which I do not understand why. I mean, this is so dumb. Black people, especially the Black same gender loving community, there are certain things that Black same gender loving people don't like on their name. And one is molestation when it comes to little children. That's something people always put on same gender loving people. And then also AIDS or HIV. So I don't understand why anybody in a Black body would then do the work of the white man and slander another Black person with HIV that they blame on Africa. I mean, it's just, I'm like, you have got to be the most uneducated, dumb motherfucker I pay on these streets. You really are.
I just want to say this, that that's kind of what people expected you to give to William, who actually said that and who did exactly what you're describing that these other people have done. Like, that's what he did.
Yeah, that's what he did.
I think that's what, but everything that you're saying here, I think is what people were expecting you to go into and to really wangle him up because of
on his platform.
Yeah.
No, I wouldn't have done that. You probably would have, but I wouldn't have done that. I wouldn't have done that. And I was trying to disappear the whole conversation at that point because I'm saying, okay, I see Consciouztv, he got triggered because Conscious had dragged him and took him to court. Okay, so let me just move out of that conversation, go on to the next thing. Because that was the first time me and him was live together since 2019. You know, when we had done it three or four times prior, collaborating for the church. You know, so I wasn't going to take that energy there. And people have a problem with this, they have a problem with it. I mean, I don't care. My only concern was you and is you. And that's why I'm here.
So before we move into the facts, I just want to say that I think it was extremely telling about how much this person really respects you, because he said in his statement, "I know that's your friend," which meant that he knew exactly what he was doing. And I don't know what he thought about you, but whatever he thought about you, he thought what he did was going to be excusable. I don't know how that translates. I don't know how you show up in a way that even made him believe that it was okay to speak like that about me in front of you, but there's a lot of information in the fact that he even did what he did in front of you. And once again, he knew what he was doing, because saying this in front of you is why all of this is happening to begin with. So I think maybe there's some things you need to unpack in why he would set you up in the way that he did, and whatever level of respect he really doesn't have, that he would disrespect you in that way as it relates to somebody that he knows that you have a relationship to.
Well, I think if he thought that prior to that and it was calculated, I think in that moment, he knew that didn't fly, because he moved on and he hadn't said anything since. So if he did do that, which I can't be 100%, but if I would accept that as that was something he was trying to do, to see what I would say, because he felt like...
I don't think it was calculated in the sense that he came into the situation, but he knew what he knew before he said what he said. Mm-hmm. And when you brought my name up, he knew exactly what he was about to do. And he knew who he was about to do it in front of. He knew who he was about to try. So it became calculated in the moment that it was all happening. Like, once you brought my name up, he knew, regardless of this being the so-called man's friend, let me say what I say, because either he's going to let me slide, or
and I didn't
slide, or et cetera.
And I didn't let him slide. I just didn't handle it the way that everybody wanted me to handle that, but I'm okay with that.
So I think
maybe what he did worked, because if he was calculating it, I mean, because it's like it's distracting from what the discussion need to be. The discussion is, which was the discussion we were having. The discussion need to be, why is HIV a Reid?
So are y'all going to have that discussion?
We were having it.
Oh, publicly, I mean, since.
Yeah, that's what we were having. That's what happened. Let me tell you what happened prior. That was, if you go back in the video, that's what we were discussing. But then he switched, because I thought he was talking about the other person.
So y'all were having a conversation about why is a health Reid a Reid, and then he health Reid.
There you go. Now that happened.
So then you know that it was calculated.
that happened. And anybody watching saw that happen. And the evidence is still like this. Exactly what happened. So I was like, okay. And that has moved ahead from the conversation.
Yeah. So speaking of moving ahead from the conversation, I really thought about the way that I wanted to have this conversation. You guys know that I will feed off a bitch's bones, and I will eat the flesh literally off the skeleton and leave no stones unturned. But then I thought about how there's kind of no reason to do that, because the facts in this case windmill for themselves. And I also had to consider the fact that I have followers who have HIV. I have mm-hmm. friends who have HIV.
Mm-hmm.
I have people who see this who have HIV. So instead of dirtying this up more than what it needs to be dirtied up,
mm-hmm.
I'm just going to politely, first and foremost, demonstrate to you all and show you all the person who said that I have HIV. This is who said that. about this. That's who said that about me. Now, ironically, I had a doctor's appointment. And I did my annual checkup because I'm a beautiful bitch and I don't play about my sexual health, because I eat well, I live well, I date well, and beauty is literally my market. Okay? So I have to be well, especially to access the things that I access. So as a result, I take really good care of myself, and veganism has me popping and glowing and all of those things. So Monday, I had an appointment to do my usual blood work, et cetera. And guess what I got done? I got done a HIV screening. And this are the results of my HIV tests as of March the 25th. Monday at 9:42 to be exact. And what does that say, class? Non-reactive. Oh my God. Is that an HIV screening from Davion's eye chart, my chart here? Is this an HIV 1-2 combo screening? And it reads what again, class? Oh, non-reactive. But I can do you one better, because while I was setting up this live, my actual doctor had messaged me on my chart. So let's go and access my actual my chart, because he further corroborated. Let me access my chart real quick, because he further corroborated this testing. Okay. Mm-hmm. That would be access code. Shout out to my chart for all of the security. 015, that is. Okay. Let's get in this bitch. Messages. Let's go to test results. Where we at? Okay, here it is. Let me pull up my chart. Let's do that, class. Here's Miss My Chart. All right. So my doctor actually messaged me at 7:08 p.m., just 30 minutes before this live, and said, Davion, your cholesterol, electrolytes, and kidney functions all look great. No need to make any changes at this time. Oh, and your HIV and Hep C screening tests were also negative. And there's that old nasty piece of non-reactive right there at the bottom of the screen. Zoom in and screenshot that, everyone. Let's hope the truth travels as fast.
But you know,
as the salacious lies told.
Well, they don't. And the reality is,
that's why I'm here windmilling for myself. Because yeah, if I don't, it damn sure ain't going to be up.
Mm-mm, it's not. I mean, because the way that they, I mean, we've seen that from watching your work for the last 2 years. You put up the facts in black and white, pulling it from Google, pulling it from the court, and it doesn't matter. These people still continue to say whatever they say because they don't like you. And when somebody does not like you, they are not going to do due diligence in finding out what the truth is. They're just going to parrot what is salacious. And the reality is, the people in the comment section, they're just as guilty for clicking on it, watching it, viewing it, knowing that people are doing nothing but sabotaging another person they don't like, their career, their name, their brand. They're muddying up their algorithm on YouTube. When I typed in your name to find something, we was talking the other day, that video from the other vlogger came up saying that you had HIV. The first video before I got normally when I do that, whatever you did last come up, or either what you've done in the last week, sometimes the last 2 weeks. That is a strategy. It's a money game. It's horrible. It's dark. It's demented. And it's not even something that I think a whale human would even do to somebody else. The reality is, even with this non-reactive, which is very clear, everybody know who my chart is. Everybody know who them diagnostic play, but there's like...
Let me explain super quick what my chart is. My chart isn't something that can be manipulated. My chart is something that's uploaded straight from your doctors. Mm-hmm. It's uploaded straight from the physician's office. These test results and screenings and all the information in your my chart come straight from the source themselves, but go ahead.
Yeah, that's right. That's what I'm saying. I mean, we know that.
No, I'm just saying this for people who may don't know this. There's a lot of people who don't know things they should be, in fact, knowing, such as the fact that a lot of people don't know that despite, because I've had to explain this to people when it came to the allegations of HIV against you, that no amount of medicine on the market is going to actually, it only treats HIV. It does not cure you of HIV. So for a lot of people in your case who were saying, well, he's taking medication which allows you to be undetectable, therefore that's why your test can come back negative. People are so stupid and so medically uneducated. It's really a shame because people out here having sex. And if this is, and if they don't know the basics of how sex and STI and STDs work, that's really a shame. But the medication treats your viral load. But the reason why somebody who's even on medication is still going to test HIV positive, regardless of being on PrEP, right, or regardless of being on HIV treatment medication, is because the actual test tests for HIV antibodies. It doesn't test for your viral load. So it doesn't matter if somebody is undetectable, they're still going to test HIV positive. The medication does not allow you to test negative. Freaks.
Correct.
So when you say, you know, people know this, no, people don't, because I have seen the conversations and think pieces all around social media, even as it relates to, once again, your controversy, and people were literally toting that misinformation about how HIV medication works.
They still do. But it's after you done show how many tests for how many years. I mean, these
actually,
people.
Actually, I have your most recent one if you just want to go ahead under convenience.
I know. This is the thing. So they'll say I went, like they did the last test, the last two tests, actually. I don't want nobody to think I'm going to get no test because somebody out there telling a lie. They don't know that in my community, we do these testings, not for HIV, but it just go with it. It's, and not for any STI, really. It's,
and
really,
that's how I snatched it. Because this is what we do as patrons all the time. We get our annual blood work done.
I don't care. I don't care. You put it up. I don't care. I don't care.
Okay. But, so go ahead while, and you know, just while we're here, I mean, it's, I mean, it might as well. I mean, you know, while everybody's all happening, let me show my other test, because I got another test done last year. Because once again, I'm a pretty bitch. Okay, this is what I do, honey. Okay, you're never gonna catch me slipping, bitch. Okay, not only do I show paperwork, I require paperwork in order to lay down. Okay, I do not play when it comes to my sexual health at all. Okay, I don't need no type of issues. But this is another test. Okay, this came from doctor's care. I went in for some blood work and also got an HIV screening there. Mm-hmm. And what, even as of last year, okay, 06/20/2023, you can see that I had an HIV done. And guess what? Antigen and HIV 1-2 antibodies were not detected. There is no laboratory evidence of an HIV infection. You guys should get you some. But while we're here, let's go ahead and move into Dr. Reid, who also maintains his sexual health, his overall health.
You gotta move the banner, Conscious. It's blocking some of your stuff.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Oh, there it is at the bottom. You see those beautiful words? There's no laboratory evidence of an HIV infection. No antibodies or anything were detected. Once again, non-reactive. That was last year, too. I wonder how many of these whores, heathens, and niggas are getting tested. Because I wonder I get finished showing Dr. Reid's paperwork. You can explain your lab court results if you want to, Dr. Reid.
You probably can do better than me, because you, but you just look
down. Okay, right at the top of the screen. There it is. Boom.
Oh, no, you go down to the bottom. It's at the bottom. It's at the bottom. Yeah.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah, at the bottom. This is the thing. And although we're doing this, anybody who is watching, I mean, a lot of you, and some of you I know personally, because I coach you. Let me say this. Whether yours say non-reactive or reactive, that I don't want you to feel any kind of way because we're having to. It's not like we're trying to prove that we don't have some horrible, terrible, deadly death sentence. It's not that. It's just the lie aspect. It's the same reason why Conscious had put up 159,000 receipts as relates to so many different stories. It's just comparing the truth with the lie. And anybody who has said Conscious or myself have HIV, and anybody that will say that, you need to know what quality of platform you're listening to and run. You shouldn't be participating in somebody's conversation like that. That's a low vibratory frequency where somebody won't even check for receipts. They will not look for the truth. They just say different stuff out of their mouth because they don't like the person. Even after this, they're going to say, I got it. They're going to say, Conscious got it, because it goes with their narrative, because they don't like us.
And speaking of that, I want to be super clear about why I did this, because unlike some of the commenters, I did not do this to prove anything to social media. Right. I actually did it for one reason and one reason only, to prove liars as liars. Mm-hmm. That's why I know the truth. I don't actually have nothing to prove. You know why? Because I'm not fucking there, none of y'all, on the internet. So mm-hmm. I don't give a fuck about whether y'all think I'm positive or not. My dick and ass don't go nowhere to not near subscriber, near nigga on my YouTube, TikTok, Snapchat, etc. Okay? So it's irrelevant to me whether people think I'm positive or not. But since people like the blogger who touted this in front of you and the blogger who got 1 million robots on YouTube like to talk themselves as credible people, they like to talk themselves as actual journalists. They like to talk themselves as truth tellers. This was just an opportunity to show that once again, these niggas and bitches don't have a single lick of truth in them, baby.
And I don't know why the commenters, because see the way my audience do, they won't let me just, I mean, they know I ain't gonna tell no lie, but they ain't gonna let me just say stuff and I don't have no receipt, something that, at least circumstantial evidence, but I do more than circumstantial, but at least as some form of evidence that proves the narrative that you pushing. Why ain't y'all holding them people accountable? You know why? Because you got the same spirit they got, the same vibration, and you harmonize energetically with that filth. So what I want every blogger that is listening in the bushes to realize, you're next. And the people that you are clicking on your video that's giving you a Google AdSense check, that these people are going to do exactly what you're doing to me and to Conscious with this HIV read. They're going to do it to you concerning something else. The way the universe set up, you reap what you sow. You only sow, and you only can come to yourself. So if that's the way you're doing your platform, that's who watching you. And those same people are going to do the exact same thing to you.
I just once again want to reiterate, this is why it's a joke that this was even said about me. It's a joke that it was even said about you, because the people who say these things have no credibility, and continuing to prove that they have no credibility will continue to make what they say on their platforms at best just entertainment.
Mm-hmm.
At best just entertainment, because we know that these folk don't tell no truth. So, you know, I wish that the blogger who has said this in front of you actually cared about the career he actually doesn't have for a reason. It's the reason why those videos are at 300 views, 200 views, 150 views, etc. And it's because of behavior like this. It's the reason why other people excelled in front of him. It's the other reason why other people got to the head of the line. It's the other reason why people actually made it a success and made it a business and made it their legacy and an actual career. While he's still stuck on Facebook at 200 views. There's a reason why that happened. And this is the reason why. Because when you don't tell the truth and you don't do your job and you're stupid and you're willing to walk into lawsuits after lawsuits, you're willing to tout lies, you're willing to extort, this is why you sit there on Facebook in front of 50 people begging for cash apps. This is why you got to have a million robots on YouTube and then have a backup channel and a backup app, because you owe another bitch 4 million plus Bitcoin. Because you don't specialize in the truth. Now you got to convert them currencies. And now you got to try to defraud Cardi B and then walk your ass into defrauding the government. And now your civil suit, your bankruptcy suit, will turn into a criminal one.
And let me say this, because somebody is saying lawsuits. No, not that. They said suit for defamation. And Conscious can speak on this too. Look.
Bruh. I live in the state of Georgia because they don't move as slow like in the states of Ohio.
Yeah, but even with that, it's just a statement that you're really making to that person, because and maybe to whoever's watching the whole thing go down, because these people don't have any money. Suing on any level makes no sense. The whole reason why Cardi B sued that particular blogger is to make a statement to her. She knew that she did not have what she will win. But she did want to take whatever she did have to make a statement to her, which now, I mean, I couldn't imagine being in her shoes, because having to get paid different ways and change how you move and all that, it's just not worth it. And I just would not do that. So those of you that are saying to us to sue, let me speak for myself. I have sued several people online. And it, when I look back at it, I hate that I use hundreds of thousands of dollars to do it.
I'm actually taking a contrary opinion to Dr. Reid. I actually think that lawsuits are super amazing. For one, lawsuits in this case is why Unhinged with Budweiser K, Unhinged and Unwinding with Cardi B's money. This is the reason why she's going to be going to jail. Because, see, Cardi B might not have gotten what she paid for on the front end. Oh, but she's going to get due justice on the back end because of the games that Unhinged played in order to move around this judgment. The embezzlement, the bankruptcy fraud, the contempt of court, even the blogger that you're talking about. The reason why he can't get a car or get an apartment in his name and has to live out of extended stays is because of the bankruptcies. It's because of the lawsuits. The lawsuits did all that. So, to your point, yes, they don't stop people sometimes on the front end. But when you get really low vibrational people who have no integrity and they also try to cheat and play these ball-headed hoe games with the system itself, those people walk themselves into the situations that got the blogger that said what he said in front of you living the way he living, and there got Unhinged ass living the way she living, and got her ass on the way to prison, and got her baby, her son, over in a continent and in a particular country where one out of two people carry HIV.
So is that true? That's that she don't have you? You sure?
She don't have, in the words of T.S. Madison, that football head ass son. He is in the African continent with Shet's relatives.
But he's young. He's young. You see what I mean? That is stupid. Why just going after Cardi B over and over? And now, I don't understand that. But see, look at what's the name that I sued. He's still doing the same thing.
On his way to jail as well.
Yeah. Because you're making sure of that.
The courts are going to make sure of that.
Yeah, but there was stuff that my lawyer missed that you caught.
Well, that's because I'm the realty.
No.
It's stuff that I caught the courts don't even catch. I'm the realty. No. But see, I know that's why the rest of these girls out here are pressed about me, because I'm the realty. Everything that I blogger, the blogger said what he said, because I'm what he wants to be. I'm the credibility. I'm the beauty. I'm the ambiance. I'm the intelligence, the intellect, the wit, I'm the gag. I'm her. I'm her. Mm-hmm. And that goes for the rest of these girls too. Okay? Because they know where I sit and they know how I sit. So
I agree with that. I do agree with that. I do think number one reason that folk come for you is because of your talent. For some, it may even be because they know that you got money, that you look good. I think that's number one. And then number two, as relates to these beefs amongst these, I think it has everything to do with our friendship.
For sure.
And they know we fuss, they know we don't agree, and then we continue to still be cool. And I think that's a little bit jealous.
And possibly, I have never seen anything like that. I went into some detail about our interpersonal relationship and what the level of friends that we operate on. Mm-hmm. And it's so authentic and raw to its core that even me and you ain't never seen nothing like it before. Even me and you are able to have levels of conversation and confrontation that is not even something that you're used to, because you're an Aquarius. An Aquarius like the and so the level of communication and the level of support, because I also wanted to remind the followers, I understood from an optic perspective why they felt the way they felt about the way that it looked.
I get it too. Although I said fuck yeah, I do get it. But
let me add my butt first. But
that's what they said. You like to add your butt first, what they said.
What? Oh, it's a big one too. I got a big butt. So but it's because, you know, I had wanted to remind them too that I don't want them. I know that this here is a lot. The social media is a lot. But I wanted to remind them that they're only seeing the tip of the iceberg when it comes to you and I. They don't see the actual friendship. They don't see that. They so trying to make a lot of assumptions and conclusions about us through this medium is a lot like trying to surmise who people are through reality TV episodes. Right.
About anybody, really. You can't do it through the internet. You can't. You really can't do it.
But you can add a your butt too.
I done forgot what my ass was gonna say.
I think that we were talking about not the level of friendship and people not seeing everything.
Yeah, you can't really get, you can't see that from the outside, but what you can see, judge our work as an extension of our character. And I want you to do it for everybody online. And if you do that, you're going to change who you watch and who you click like on. Because if your work is so demented to where you will say somebody have HIV and push that narrative around or any lie on them without any evidence and any research, you are an entertainer. And nobody should take you serious on any story or any commentary that you give.
Is it, you know, I don't like to quantify, but, you know, there are moments that I want to brag on you, but I don't, because it's not necessary. But, I mean, when conversations like this come up as it relates to the dynamics of the friendship, I just want to say that me and you, we rally for each other, we support each other, and once again, you say my name everywhere, which I
everywhere.
Think, and not only do you say my name, I had to remind the supporters as well that y'all guys forget the times that he's also publicly windmilled for me, such as the night that we fell out with Unhinged.
Mm-hmm.
She's the reason why you entered the chat, because she was like, call your mentor. And she thought that her clout and her subscriber base, she was expecting you to hit her.
She told me to choose between her and you.
Well, hold on. I want to get there yet. I want to talk about the social media part, because she thought you was going to hit that link over there first. But you hit this one first, and not only did you hit it first while she was over there waiting for you, but you also hit it first and said, uh-uh, boo, CTV told the truth. I don't know what the hell you talking about. CTV stated the facts. And then after you had came over here, optically showed up when you're supposed to, and you backed me up, then you went over there and let her cry to you. Yeah. And then, yes, after that, she also tried to give you an ultimatum.
But I don't know why would she even think that she could. I guess she thought I was enamored.
Has she seen this? Like, what the hell was Tasha thinking? Hey, are you kidding me, Tasha? Me? You try to you can't petition a bird, baby, away from me. Are you kidding me? That's how I knew she had some ego issues for her. I said, the woman is a dude, you know. This woman ain't looked in the mirror. This woman didn't have fupa. This woman ain't seen herself in ages for her to have the unmitigated gall to literally try to petition a man. To back up off of me, but you can't petition a woman to do that, let alone a damn man. But anyway.
Yeah, I still don't look, you know, in the heat of all of that. One thing that I am guilty of, I'm an Aquarius. And I have the positives and only a few of the negatives. And one is being aloof and detached. And I don't always pay attention to what's going on online. And then when I'm told certain pieces, I hear it and not hear it. And I may show up less than aware of all of the moving parts that's happening out here on the internet. It's going to always be like that because it's my character trait and personality that when it's a whole lot of going back and forward, and conscious can verify this, I check out. And then I have to get to myself and think and then show back up saying what maybe I should have said, but definitely what I want to say. And that I am guilty of. And I think that may be played into how I handled William, but please note that I was saying, and if you got the clip, you know I'm not lying. I was saying, but it was going out because it was his platform. He was louder than me. So I was saying, I said, yeah, that's my friend. That's right. And he don't even have no. And then he spoke over me and you couldn't hear what I said. But you saw my lips move. I would not have went into attack mode on his platform. That was our first time being live in several years. We had just had a conversation. In fact, I was sort of guarded, and as we kept talking, I was more comfortable because he had called me almost a week before, maybe, and that's when, and Concha knew about this, and knew the let bygones be bygones conversation, and everything was fine. We picked up right from where we left off, had Carlton Pearson conversation about the content he did on my mentor and all this kind of stuff. And he even said in that live how there was things I gave him pointers on. And I was just being a friend to William. If you go back to the lives I did on the platform with him years ago, I was trying to present and show, listen, he ain't all bad, although he's done X, Y, Z. So that was a sense of the situation. So I wasn't going to go in, like, checking him on this platform. Uh-uh, he don't have X. How you know? Da-da-da. I just let it play out. And, like, Conscious, you really saw earlier when I said it, we were having a conversation about not putting HIV on people. And then out of the blue, he said what he said.
And that's exactly what people
think. Yeah.
Larry, people, you have carved out a brand at this point of being Mr. Accountable. And if you can speak truth to power and TD Jakes and the powers that be and the church, people expect you to be able to speak to a nobody about HIV. And y'all sitting there having a conversation about not using health reason, then not only are they use against somebody that he knows you're close to. Mm-hmm. Like, people are going to expect that out of you. Like, it's like people see you as a man at this point. Like, they don't expect any boy anything. So yes, they expect you to be able to be Larry. They expect you to be bold enough and enamored enough to swing, because that's who Larry Reid is. Larry swings on bigger forces than this 200 views on Facebook, bitch.
But, you know, I hear that, and that's a fair assessment, but it's not considering mine. So I'm just going to leave that right there. But that is, to me, that's compared apples and oranges. And one big thing is that has to be considered, or that I consider, is that the sensitivity of reconnecting and being on somebody else's platform, I wouldn't have done that. So I spoke with him later, and that's how I handled that.
I think that bloggers using HIV is deplorable.
It's horrible.
I think that health readers are really tired. I think it's really, and so now that we're here, can we see the blood work of Unhinged?
Oh, my God.
Bartholomew McWig the 12th. I need y'all blood work now, because see, I know what y'all not gonna bring to the table. I know what apps y'all not gonna open up. But Wilhelmina, since you wanted to clear me on a positive result, we need to see your results now, and we will be waiting, because the way that this here is set up, baby, you can't tell me that positive ain't going to run from top to bottom of every damn test.
Oh, Jesus.
Because, see, nobody who looks like that and who been in the game for 20 years and still streaming in front of a motel lamp and nightstand could even have the unmitigated gall to lay such a burden upon anyone. We need to test results on that skin, on that wig glue, on those nails, on those feet, on that botched BBL, because what you're testing positive for is a failure. Failed across the board, baby. Miss Unhinged failed, bitch. Because let me tell you something, girl. On any day, I would rather be HIV positive and be in zero debt. Okay? Catch that.
Oh, they're gonna use that clip.
Any day, I would prefer to be an HIV positive person who is healthy with zero remaining dollars on the tab, bitch. Nobody wants to be you at $4 million in debt. If that's what HIV negative looks like, bitch, you can hand me a healthy positive in return.
They're going to use that clip.
And should.
Oh, boy.
Spin it so that can get 70,000 views and 30,000 views and 40,000 views. Because, see, this is the thing, Larry. For me, HIV is not even a read. I'm too woke. Personally, and I'm too educated on HIV to be somebody who thinks that that's a shame, because to think that would be to think that my friends and relatives who are positive are to walk around in shame.
Well, see, why they don't ever
that's not even a read. If I was HIV positive, I would be doing what Justin J. Kingarese is doing, talking about my shit, creating spaces around conversations around HIV positivity and living, etc.
Yeah.
I'm not a bitch who lies. I stand on business and I stand on truth, and I own all of it, bitch. All of it. From head to tizzo. See, the reason you hoes got a lot on me is because I am the truth.
Yes, that's it.
I feel honored.
Is that a cash app?
Yes.
Because people love you. That's the only reason.
It's the reason. This only reason I'm here is for the people, but to expose once again the holes inside of the holes. And I just want to say that. Okay, I fucked up my train of thought there, but nonetheless, you hoes hate me because I was going to say that honestly, I'm honored. Because if the worst thing you got to say about me, baby, is that I'm positive, boo, and that's not a read, because nobody who is positive is sitting on E.
Mm-hmm.
Being positive ain't stopping not near, baby. Ain't stopping not near, nigga. All the people that I know who positive, fucking like it ain't nothing, got a real healthy, frequent, fluid sex life, got marriages, children, etc. HIV ain't stopping a damn thing. So there's not even a shame or a read in that. But what I think is deplorable is the fact that these people have a platform and they want a platform. And this is who they're willing to be with the platform. This is what they're willing to do. What he did and what she did. This is what they want a platform for. And this is what some of them want your help to help them to create, is a platform so they can be the ugly, terroristic, defamatory motherfuckers that they are. And they want to come through a credible motherfucker like you. Mm-hmm. Because they get to vicariously snatch up some of that credibility so that they can continue on in their evil doing.
Mm-hmm. Let me sit with that.
Are there any other questions, chat? Because I think we're complete, Dr. Reid.
Oh, God. Yeah, for all of those that are still saying you should have vehemently defended your friend, I defended him the way that I defended him. And I'm sorry that it does not meet your level of whatever you wanted out of me on somebody else's platform. That could have hit X and went out and however. But it happened the way it happened, and I hope you get over it. If Conscious isn't out here fussing at me about it, then what the hell are you doing? I mean, I don't understand what you want. Do you want to suck a dick?
At the end of the day, and like I said last night, I said, of course, as a personal preference, I said, of course, any human being wants to see energy match. That's just a human thing. I said, of course, my preference would have been for Larry to absolutely kick the ass and knock the bitch through the door over me. I said, but I'm also mature enough to know that at the end of the day, Larry did stand up. He stood up in his way, but he stood up, and when he stood up, shit had shut down. So he shut it down.
Somebody asked me why I didn't, after someone I was associated with went live about a month ago and terribly dragged those that were around me, which nobody still don't understand why he did that. But and I went live, I didn't show up like that. I just said, these are good people, leave them alone. And they don't have nothing to do with me. I heard someone say that I should have done more. You don't know, you ain't looked at my track record. I don't even do it for myself. The only thing you'll get out of me, it got a benefit, because when I'm live, I'm attempting to inform people, but I'm also trying to entertain people, make them laugh. And versus telling lies on folk, I choose to pull up comments that come in the comment section, drag those people, and make everybody laugh and give them all of this entertainment to make them laugh. I choose my entertainment differently. I'm not going to get up here and put HIV on people and domestic violence on people that ain't did this to keep you engaged. So I haven't done it. Show it to even when my own mama was brought into this in 2019, I didn't do it. So that's what you're going to get from me. That's my friend. Conscious is my friend. Change the conversation, because we're not having that kind of conversation. And that's how it's going to be. And I will continue to, hey, Cheryl's World. I really like her. I'm going to continue to be that type of dude. Even with Unhinged, I have not dragged her yet. Not yet. Any of these people online, I don't even come like that. And the reality is I really can't, because whenever I go live, I don't care if it's 100 people. I know who's watching me. I know why they're watching me. And that's how I got picked by BET from my platform. I'm very calculated in how I move. And I can be calculated in how I move and benefit the platform at the same time, show up for my friends. And the way that I decided to show up was, Conscious is my friend, changing the subject. And he moved on. If it wasn't enough for you, then oh, hell, oh, well.
I was giving you props, a lot of props last night, Larry, because I know that I had a conversation with you last night, and you was like, I'm always okay with you telling these people how you get in my ass.
Yeah, I always say that.
Last nerve. And I was telling them that, because this is the stuff they don't see. Like, they really don't understand that I am a heart-centered, right-brain empath. You are a left-brain empath. Mm-hmm. And so our love language styles are kind of different.
Mm-hmm. Very different. Very different.
And what's funny about that, Larry, is like people in the chat were saying Larry is very transactional. Now they were actually saying that to be shady, but the reality was
that's like, very true
that you say that because he's an Aquarius.
Oh my god! Who said that? That's true.
No, like they were saying it in a shady.
They
weren't saying it in an enduring poetic way. They were saying it in a shady way. But I have flipped it and reversed it and said, but it's ironic that even with that looking the way that it does, I said, he's an Aquarius and Aquarius are like that. Like y'all love language is around gifting and doing.
Yeah.
And y'all like to also do stuff and give stuff to people. That's what y'all do.
Yeah.
I'm an empath, so like my love language is around like verbal affirmation and kind of like sentimental stuff like that. That's the stuff that.
Yeah, and you know what? Just now, this is a great conversation that you're waking me up. God really was calm. Very true, and that's really been at the root of all of our fusses. Well, not all of them, but in all of our quite a few of our fusses. Because my love language in a friendship or any relationship is totally different than Conscious. And I'm going to say what I say to Conscious if you want me to retract that because it's too much to share out here. I said to him, I said, Conscious, this is the reason why I ain't married right now. You get on my last nerve and hang up.
Ain't going to.
I'm an entire nigga. Now I turn on the feminine for funny. I'm a church boy, so they some there. And I go into that Larry live voice, you know. But I can't do all that. When it gets to being like that, I'm like, I'm gonna let you go.
But this is the thing though, see y'all. Can y'all see how these niggas do? But this is the thing, right? But look at all he get in return. So it's worth look at all that come with that. It come with knowing that you got a bitch who will run into the house on fire for you, who will run into the eye of the storm, somebody who will lay their life down, someone who is deeply trustworthy, integral, you ain't gonna never have to worry about. Now, you might got to fight with them on some personal shit, but you ain't gonna never have to worry about no outside contamination, you never to worry about none of that bullshit. You get a total 100 mother lover. So, you know, all good things come with a price.
Yes, it's true.
I said, Larry asked, like, because his love language is transactional and doing, I could probably, it is easier for me to get Larry to put me on a private jet than it is.
Wow.
To have to get emotional out of
that's pretty insightful. That's pretty insightful. That's pretty insightful. Pretty insightful. Wow.
So I always tell Larry that it's a reason why he has a lot of feminine energy in his life, whether it be his daughters, his ex-wife, whether it be in the queer people, that he has this femininity in his life because he got a lot of masculine energy. I know he gets a lot of slack for quote unquote coming off gay, but the way Larry moves is very masculine in all actuality. His mannerisms may be flamboyant, but the way he actually moves, he's very
cerebral. I'm a whole nigga. And that's why women love me. That's why Lisa was in love with me. I mean, it's just my daughters run to me as a protector. And it's in my documentary. I am wired as a protector, and I'm every bit of what you just said. And to see that, and you know me, that is very, very, very true. Now, that's very true. That's very true.
I told her last night, I said, look, y'all, I'm a Scorpio, so you know, like my eyes on my people. I be observing behind y'all necks, behind y'all, and like my spiritual eyes. I be all up in my people's shit. I know y'all psychology. I know how y'all work and how y'all function. I be looking with that eye there.
Yeah.
And
wow.
Larry is being tested and tried with this feminine energy. So a lot of this feels like he has to kind of manufacture it because it won't come natural to him. And I realize that's what's happening too. Is because I'm right brain, the left brain shit don't come natural to me. I have to manufacture it. But it's a righteous forcing because it's balance I do need. I do need that left brain balance
in my life. I need the right brain balance
in your life.
And it is everybody around me, including the straight men around me, are more emotional than me. You know, and I'm like, what's okay? That's a lot. You know, I like it really easy, breezy. And the feminine energy is very complex because it's very powerful. It's very layered and very complex. And when in my spirituality and in my creativity, I get into the feminine energy, like my personal prayer time, how I do my workings and all my
We've been doing witchcraft and Patreon, y'all.
Right, my spiritual work. Yeah, the good kind. All my spiritual, my spiritual work and my creativity and stuff, you know, that's, I get into it like that. But the way that I emote, the way that I show up, is very masculine. Very masculine. And I have to purposefully make sure that those that are around me who need that from me, I have to purposefully do that. And a lot of times they do show up in a gift. That's it, show up in a gift in a couple of words. And but I mean it, it's from my heart. And it's with all of my heart.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I think you stood up for me in how you stand up. And the bigger issue, it would have been you just not standing at all. But you did stand.
Yeah. I ain't gonna do that. And then after we had a conversation, he was like, okay, I get it. He said, I hate doing this. I don't like be between nobody, but I'm gonna say this part since I done said it. He said, I wasn't trying to put you between anything. I'm just responding back to him because he attacked me. I said, well, that's y'all conversation. If y'all ever want to have a conversation between y'all, I don't want to be in between that at all. I have a relationship with you since 2012. I've had a very strong relationship with him for several years. I said, I don't want to be involved in that.
I told them last night that your daughters chose me.
What you mean?
The daughters chose me, baby. Okay. I mean, sorry, all are called, but few are actually chosen. But let me ask you this question, Larry.
Mm-hmm. Right, Phyllis, and I'm surrounded by earth science. I'll go ahead.
The work that you've done over the years, because you have stood in the gap for a lot of people. You've stood up for a lot of people. You've called out a lot of things. And you also came under fire for standing up for a lot of things. You ended up in some legal situations yourself as a result of taking on some burdens.
Hmm.
Would you say that, would you consider your work to have been a drag against those people who you knew why you were standing up in the face of before? Would you call that, if they said, Larry, drag me, would that be a appropriate diagnosis of the situation?
It's whatever they want to call it. I mean, that, I don't call it that, but I mean, it's whatever they want to call it. I'm okay with that if that's what they want to say. But I mean, God and the universe know my intention. You know, my intention is just to say whatever needs to be said at that moment. Now, I will say that early on, I was 100% convinced by something that my platform was for the victim. And I shifted that, and I was very vocal about shifting that because I found out something about people who have been authentically victimized. And then I also ran into accusers who played victims, and it got me in a whole lot of stuff. And that's when I shifted my entire platform in 2019. So I did go very hard. So back then, if they said I dragged them, maybe so. I think because some part of that resonated with my own victimization. So I brought a lot of my own pain into the protecting of said victim. You know, only a handful of them was actually victims. As time went along, I found out these were accusers that played as victims who never wanted to own up to the part that they played. Yeah. Did I answer your question?
Yeah, like you said, okay. They could, you know, consider the, you know, I think it's a, you know, for me, it's interesting what you just said about what he said to you, because it's also in the clip when he would say, yeah, but your friend dragged me. And I just find it interesting that, I mean, of course, that would be the assessment from the side of somebody who wants to take no responsibility, but it also just goes to show how far away people are from taking responsibility for what they do. You cannot get sued in court successfully and the facts be the facts and the literal facts. I mean, you know, like everything that I ever covered regarding anybody, because he was the only person that I have covered on my platform, has been fact-driven. Very fact-based driven, very matter of a fact, the type of things that can get verdicts, type of things that can get penalty done, the type of things that can be objectively utilized in an actual system of court.
Now, is there anybody else doing that beside you and me? Let me think. Let's just think. I'm trying to really be, what's the one, the intellect? Pam, the intellect?
Oh, Pam. Esquire, yep. Pam, okay. Of course.
Okay. So who else? And it's a shame we got to sit here and try to think.
The lead attorney?
Oh, yeah, but he's not even trying to prosecute, but he only stick with the facts like Pam. So, yeah, the lead attorney.
Okay, how long? So, outside of lawyers, because, you know, lawyers are going to lawyers.
Right, exactly, right.
But there probably is some people out there, but I guess...
Maybe we don't know. Don't know them.
And I guess also... we probably struggling because it's a minority.
Okay, but conscious.
Yes.
But how many folk out there doing commentary? First of all, these people, they should be called...
Everybody!
They should be called gossipers because they are not doing commentary. They're gossipers.
That's what they are.
Gossip. Yeah, there's a lot of that. Yeah, there's a lot of that. Would you say, and I gotta go, but would you say... That person, that female, you call it unhinged, has now lowered her brand down, and maybe it was always that, and I just didn't know it, to just being the queen of gossip.
Well, she was always that, yeah, for sure. She was always that. I mean, like, that's what got her in the trouble that she got in, you know, gossiping. And the reality is that she has continued to, because remember, Kevin Hart filed a lawsuit. I mean, so many lawsuits have came. R. Kelly filed a lawsuit against her. I mean, it just keeps coming. But yeah, and it is a diminishment. But I guess it also depends on what you want. Some people want to be a gossiper. Some people want to just talk about people's lives in a way that's entertaining, and they don't care if that's made up of a bunch of lies and fictitious crap. As long as it seems to be hot tea and it's going to be monetized. And unfortunately, there are audiences who also don't care about the truth. And those are the kind of people who follow these people who are interested in gossip, and they follow gossipers. And that's why she still has a following. I remember even after the Cardi B verdict happened, she
had 1,000
subscribers. But then she was so bold because she understands the science of a salacious audience.
Yeah.
Like she said, don't worry about that, girl. We'll be back in 1 million by the summer. And I'll be damned if by the summer.
Well, she dropped, she had some big stories that she done, and people came over there for the salaciousness. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And her audience says it all the time. They say, we don't know why y'all take her seriously because we don't.
Oh, I didn't know that.
For us, it's just got, yeah. A lot of the winos also follow me. They'll follow us here. And they actually also be in my DMs like, look, I'm a wino CTV, but we gonna drag her. We gonna drag Tasha. They sitting there ready for me to get in her ass. They're like, girl, we love you over there. But it was like.
Now I'm gonna say this. Now, I don't know about you. I still, if a clip come by, I watch and I get tickled. She makes me laugh.
Whatever clips I may not laugh at.
You said, oh, you're not going to tell it?
Whatever, because I may or may not laugh.
Oh, she tickled me now. Mm-hmm. She do tickle me. She does.
But that's a gag.
Yeah.
Genuinely gifted.
Entertainment.
Entertainment.
Yeah.
But my God. You know, to use this is what Paul was talking about, gifts and curse. The gifts can easily feel and become like a damn curse. And it's just unfortunate when it does. And it gets utilized for self-gain and selfishness and buffoonery. But,
if I be honest.
Yes.
And no, we're never coming back. We never get to how we were because it's not safe. It's about me and Unhinged. But
I want you to think about what I know you're about to say. Please, mister, I learned. Please.
Oh, no, I have. Listen, you can't say nothing about me past 22. When I cut in 22, it was it. And then them folk just took a while to get detached from my life, but it was out. I cut in 22. I'm not going back to how I was prior 22. But I just don't hold in my heart any. I can't hold anything in my heart. So I'm going to look at a person who has done me dog dirty wrong and be like, I still see your gift. I still love you. I can't unlove you, but I just know you're not safe for me to be in my life. You're really not safe to love. So I have to love you from over here. So, okay, I think that's a good way of saying what I was about.
That's a real good way. Okay. Right there, doc. That edit was precise and perfect. Right there. You heard that, Unhinged? The doctor still love you, baby. Even with all the hell you committed to, it'll never be ill intent on his end.
Yeah, I don't wish
you accountable depending on how you give it up sometime, but no. Never going to be ill on his end because he ain't got that in him.
No.
And I don't either. Like a whole gag. I don't got it either in me, doctor.
Yeah, I know that. I know that about you.
Unhinged. I drag her because I'm who God is using to draw her into repentance. Yes. That's my job in the Holy Land, doctor. Okay. Drag into utter repentance. I'm the pressure. I'm the divine pressure. So that's my assignment in the earth, and I'm sticking to it.
Mm-hmm. Now, I hear you confess that she make you laugh when you see a clip come across.
And she enjoy me because she be hoverboard and she be right here.
But you know what?
Watching my stories on Instagram. That bitch is entertaining. Miss her friend too, because I was good to Tasha. I was good to Tasha. I was good to KB Studios. When they came over here with all they mess and all they ghetto-ness, I was good to them people. I helped them people. The people had me tied in front of the screen and behind the screen. And I was there for those people. There for them. And she knows it too.
She's talented. And the other person that you don't want me to mention their name, talented.
Ooh. Hold on. A hint.
No.
Texted. What?
I texted because I ain't trying to get into nobody, nothing.
Yeah, because we need to stay on theme. If it's on theme, like the title. The title of the video.
Okay. I'm not saying that name, but because I don't want.
Yeah. Because it ain't title related.
Right, it's not title related.
Yeah, so, and that's it. What's the point? Like, well,
I was talking about talented people that you may not like.
But see, I don't consider some of those people talented, and that's just genuine for me. A comedian you may find funny may not
true
for me, true. So, okay. But, Unhinged, yes, talented, a demon, a devil, and she's going
to jail. Wait a minute. Bitch, you going to talented, a demon, and a devil. Is that what you said?
Talented, demon, and a devil, and going to jail. Bitch, you going to jail. Okay?
And you know what? You know what? I hope that doesn't happen, but I was listening to, it's just a very smart person, not a big platform. And if I pray this doesn't happen. But if she really did what they said she did in bankruptcy court,
she did.
Mm-hmm. Conscious, then she is going to it. It may be 2 years from now.
Audio, Larry. She lied. they literally reported she lied. She blatantly, because they put the transcripts and everything, and you could hear the bankruptcy, like, attorneys and lawyers and powers that be, like, they were literally asking her questions that we know on paper and in legal document. She lied. She lied on paper, and she lied directly to their face, and that's why her case got referred to the criminal. It's actually been referred.
That's not that.
So it's just a matter of time.
That's
it. That's why she out here getting these lawyers together.
That's it. It's just time. It's just time. Like what I said about the bishop. I saw the evidence, so I knew that was a done deal. Now me calling, he was gonna be locked up in 4 months, and that was prophetic. But when it comes to, well, he got released. But when it comes to like the FBI thing, mm-hmm. I was. Let me say this. Let me be careful. How am I going to say this? They did not have all of the information that they needed. They called me because of what I said publicly, led them to believe I knew more, and I gave it to them. Mm-hmm. So I knew that there was no coming out. And they shared a lot, which I'm still not going to say, because I don't know if I can still get in trouble, because they really scared me with that whole.
And you know what's funny about that, Dr. You know what? No, I'm not gonna say that. Continue on.
Okay. You know, so I knew that was going to end the way that it's ending, and we'll see July how it go. But yeah, I'm going like this. There's no way of getting out of this because this proof. And I already knew because I told you guys that he had been raided twice. So I knew that, and then what the agent told me, I said, okay, this is a done deal. You know, so that's the reason why I didn't go back live when the verdict, the conviction came. I was like, I done did my part. I know people wanted me to go live so we have a good time and chat, be entertained. It would have been fun. We've been thousands of viewers. Could have asked people for $8.88. They would have done it. It would have been a great night for us all. But the big picture is, Why am I going live? Just because if it's going to be a lot of numbers, we're going to have a good time. He already convicted. So we're just reveling in the fact that he's convicted and nanny boo boo, and then going to raise money for the nonprofit. God was going to ask, but see all them numbers, you know, help me do what the hell I'm doing. But is that what I supposed to do? And what does that make me? Like the rest of the vloggers.
Well, let me ask you this, Dr. Reid. Mm-hmm. How do you feel about the fact that he, in about 3 months, is going to have to become the big old homosexual he claimed you was?
You know what? Conscious?
Ow!
Why is he?
I'm just asking the hard questions here. That's all.
Wait a minute. Why you say he got to become one? Cause when he get in jail, what you say?
Cause he real short.
How you know that?
And he real stout.
Oh my God.
And he got a real big throat.
Oh my God. Now he do have DSL.
I think it's just ironic.
You know, I don't hate that man. You know, and I, you know what we're going to do? I'm going to call him and say, let's have an interview. Fly him here and just listen to it. And let's get us. I'm never going to forget what he did and the part he played. But he really was trying to develop a friendship with me. And because of his energy, it just... I don't know if it's because of all of what he was, but it just wasn't a match, and I never trusted. Although my mentor wanted me to embrace him, I just couldn't. And my mentor did for several months. But
I was going to say that this is also why I don't be mind dragging you about the people around you, because you be dragging the people around you about the people around them. Like you were dragging the hell out of, you was getting on Bishop Bernard Jordan ass about, why the hell you got this damn man? This man ain't no damn good. What you doing with this?
I did. I absolutely.
Larry cuts up too. Don't say that he don't get his Scorpio on. He got Scorpio tendencies, baby.
I did. I absolutely did. And the reality is, this is how I always see people for who they are. initially. But what I tend to do and have normally what I did prior to 22, I would just push it aside, actually my ego, because I felt like if they dealt with me and had a relationship with me, how I am, it's going to make them, it's going to give them experience they've never had with love and concern, and it's going to cause them to be the best person that they could ever be, because that's normally what has happened over the years, especially them 20 years pastoring in the box.
When the people are for real.
Yeah. So, but what ended up beginning to happen when it did not work,
if people are seriously corrupted, your energy exposes that corruption.
Right. And it'd be such a bad fallout. And I'm like, you know what? So by the time I got to Lamore, and that was in top of 22, I'm like, and he would call me consistently on FaceTime. I didn't give him the time of day, because it just wasn't an easy energetic match, and with everything I had already experienced, I was done by that time. And then the nail in the coffin was unhinged. That was it. And I told somebody the other day, said, "Oh, I thought it was something." I said, "No, bro." I said, "Unhinged was it." They said, "Well, what about, you know, former contractors?" No, I knew who they were. And I expected this at some point in time. So it really wasn't that serious, you know, but unhinged, that was the one that was it. After that,
I guess you called it, the viewers did. I
everybody did. My mama did.
it was a really obvious pushback, because, you know, I'm a Patreon member, and obviously I'm a moderator for your platform. Mm-hmm. So I remember even when you put up the flyer and you did the Patreon, right, that you was bringing home, I remember the chat was filled with, "No, Larry, no." I mean, people were like, just like, "No, no, true. No,
true.
No, 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 no,
Larry."
That's because, true. But this is why this is what you got to be careful of, because I got my ass whooped coming into this space, sincere and genuine, and that's why I had to cut people off. And then those people punished me for cutting them off by talking shit, becoming option enemies. I couldn't walk away in peace, even when I was walking away in silence. I didn't even walk away with a kaboom. I walked away in silence, and these people turned into my enemies because they had been rejected. But this is what I learned, is that I thought that everybody else made the distinctions between their egos and their jobs. And who they were as people. And I realized that a lot of people in the space with us, they do what we do. They're commentators, they're influencers, etc. But their genre is who they actually are. It's not what they do, it's who they
are. Hell yeah. Hell, that's what I said earlier.
Who they are.
That's what they do. That's what I was saying earlier. Conscious, I said, look at their work. It's really an extension of their character.
It's who they are.
Bruh, I'm good on every content creator. That's one M&M's, what, Mims.
I make it make sense.
Yeah, and I'm like, God, I feel like he's pretty cool. You know, he said some things that, I mean, concerning me, he just did not know the truth. And I said, I'm gonna reach out to him and give him the truth. And I said, "Wait a minute, Larry, man, you done did this before." And he may be a good guy, but I'm so done with people. I'm like, Sherelle, nice. I would love to be able to be on the phone with her and Perry. That's one good time, because they seem to be great people. But because I have been through, and you may be right. I know this is probably proper good, but I'm just like, I ain't getting chummy.
And what I nobody. Well, I don't. I think we should. I because we've been on a no new friends policy. I've been keeping my end of no new friends policy, because I literally can't do. I don't give a damn how I don't give a damn what the light look like from afar. I am literally done. I can't go through. I won't. I honestly feel kind of traumatized by it all. I can't. So I'm just good, and I understand. God already told me it ain't necessary either, Davion. Like, you don't need all of that. The boat moving. Everything's moving. You good, girl. So just go and just be still and be good and know that I am God. And that's been my, because I just can't, because, you know, I like Mims. Obviously, like, me and Sherelle developed a friendship by exception. That was not supposed to happen, but it happened. So she kind of is the last of the Mohegans for me when it comes to social media.
People. She's a good girl. You can tell she's a good girl.
But this is the thing. I know that there's still some good needles in a haystack too. I'm just unwilling.
I am.
Because this stuff is getting worse and worse here. And me and another content creator yesterday was just talking about how we literally, matter of fact, me and you too, and you were talking to other content creators who drained. It's gotten so toxic and dark. And I posted something on my story, on my Instagram the other day.
And they don't even know that's what you were talking about. And one of the content creators took that and manipulated.
No, it was a post. I ain't talking about the live stream.
Oh, yeah. Well, you need to talk about the live stream. Oh, you already done it. I missed it.
I spoke about the live stream last night. I mean, the live stream, it was just, then speaking of that, the live stream was also birthed out of that
over,
like that energy, something just, I just got overwhelmed and I'm not excited anymore. I just, all the stuff with the political landscape and Trump running, and I know it's just creating what it created before. Yeah. It's just getting started again. The racism, these folks gonna have a mascot. It's already intense. It's already a lot of drama. Everything in social media algorithm is toxic. It's dark. It's heavy. It's dense. And with me being empathic and me being a very heart-centered person, kind of living in this mess is, even if it's not my personal mess, just even the outworld mess is, it just took me over, and I just wanted to go live and tell people, because I didn't even read my comments. I wasn't there to get prayer. I wasn't there to get anything. I literally was having an authentic moment of being overwhelmed, and I just felt so isolated and so detached, and so I felt like love in an unloved realm. Like I felt very opposite of what I was, or I was living in something opposite and contrasting to what I was, and it bottled up in such a way. And I said, you know what? I know, CTV, you're not the only person who feels like this. And I wanted to just go live and say, hey, I just want y'all to know you're not the only one, and you're not crazy. If you are too feeling overwhelmed and you're feeling pressed and pressured, and you just feel the world is changing and something is shifting and you're feeling this heaviness and this density, I just want you to know that life ain't picking on you. It's not just you, baby. It's a lot of us. And it's even a beautiful bitch like me. It's a fine-ass bitch like me who feeling it, baby. So don't think it's just you. Your favorite content creators feel it too. Successful. It don't matter what it the matter. Reality is.
Right now, we are all Pluto in Aquarius is pulling everything up.
And I'm ruled by Pluto. I'm a Scorpio.
Oh, that's right.
I'm a Plutonian.
Yeah. So, you know, it's pulling up everything, every feeling, every thought, even things that have been buried and hidden, and even those things that maybe it's a lie that you buried. You know, it's coming up to be discussed and disseminated. It's just what Pluto does. And with that being said, I really think that what you were doing, Conscious, on that live was important. I hate I missed it.
Yeah.
Because it looked like it was very
emotional. I gave it up, Larry. Oh, I gave that thing. And I wanted to save it. I had abruptly ended it because my battery was dying, but I didn't have time to save it. But obviously somebody screen recorded it. So I'm happy it's out there. But I wish I would have actually been able to save that, because I did that intentionally for this space. And I don't even, and that moment was so authentic that I'm not even mad at them for the way they tried to run one thing into the other and smash that together, because I didn't even know about any of that stuff that these folk were even doing, Unhinged or the other blogger. I didn't even know all that was even going on. I was literally in my own shit. I was in my own energy of where I was. And that probably was one of the most transparent, brutally naked lives I've ever done so far as a content creator. I just did not care. I wanted to wear my heart on my sleeve. I wanted to bear it all. I wanted to give it up. And I felt actually better after I felt so empowered after I had did that.
So you like I got what you did then. You might have been doing some spiritual work. Not just for yourself, but somebody that was watching too, helping them go through all of those levels.
Larry, my DMs right now are flooded.
I bet.
People flooded me out in the DMs and like CTV, what, praying for you, please pray for me. I'm going through the same thing. You just woke me up. You just inspired me. Thank you so much for being relatable, for being down to earth, for making yourself so tangible emotionally.
But see, that's the light. And see, that's the great thing about Pluto. Because see, Pluto does all of this for the purpose of ushering in an upgraded renaissance, rebirth. And that is the great thing about it. It's going to be ugly and explosive and heart-wrenching. But after it's all said and done, this is going to be really great. Oh, yeah, that's Dr. Kimberly. I know what it is. Yeah, exactly. It's not all bleak and black. Exactly.
It's like when you feel constipated and congested. It's a Pluto brings us to the awareness about constipation, if there's any constipation, if there's any type of energetic constipation, if there's any type of spiritual stuffiness, if there is any of that existing that we've been distracted from, we haven't seen, Pluto grabs that and gravitationally squeezes it in so we can feel it, perceive it, and then we can release it.
Yeah.
But we do got to do the scary thing and go into the cave. We got to go into the darkness. We got to go in that valley of the shadow of death, but trust that our healing and our ability and our solidarity is in that, because that solidness is in that stuff that you're intimidated by. That's now, the, and our healing is in that stuff that we're scared of.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is the kind of conversation I have, me and Conscious met.
Okay, hold on. Now, with that being said, this is exactly why the folk were chewing your ass up, because they're like, wait a minute, CTV, you ain't even gave you and him a show together, and you always bragging about what you and CTV do, the magic y'all got, the chemistry, and nobody even seen you hijack me up on that platform, and we get into all this stuff outside, because the only time they see you and me, Doctor, is like this. They don't see us separated and isolated and doing collaborative work like this, because this is where we shine too. This is really our blood right here.
The only person that I have had on my platform to discuss things similar to this is my mentor. I just got my platform.
And Bishop.
That's what I'm talking about, Bishop.
No, Pearson.
Oh, yeah. And he was a mentor, so yeah. But they wasn't doing it on my platform 2 years ago. We just got to that. We were having these conversations before my platform was even ready in 2018. So that is the only reason for all of you that be asking. That is the only reason that it wasn't. I will always say the concert. I said, they're not ready yet. But we're just getting to a place to where we can do something like that. And I know some hoodoo practitioners. I have all different, the Aruba, who I communicate with, and Conscious is the only Buddhist. And we're going to do that.
I'm excited.
Because I want to talk about Christianity, the parallel and the cross parts of Christianity, Jesus' teachings, and Buddhism. Because there's so many that cross.
That's giving me a spiritual nut right now. Yes. I got a spiritual nut going on right now.
Yeah, so that's just not, it's just not discussed, you know. But in my community, we do. But like the platform, the main
there
platform.
Now, though. LRLers, they there now.
Oh, yeah.
Don't vote there.
Oh, yeah, that's
true. You've been kind of spoon-feeding.
Like a year.
Yeah. And those people are there.
Yeah, they're ready for the conversation. They're ready.
I would love that. I'm excited for that. I would love for people to see all of that in real action, because I am so ready for all of that energy.
Definitely. I mean, it's time now for that. I mean, because the reality is, anybody on my platform, when I started doing more lifestyle blogging, talking about spiritual stuff, coming online by myself and doing the prophetic word, and even prophesying on the main platform, my numbers have taken a huge hit, but I don't care. I don't care about that. I mean, it's all set up for us to be stupid, toxic, blind. Because when I post some on my IG that's promoting anything that pushes people into my community, to my teaching, to my music, they hide it. But if I post something that doesn't happen in the church that's stupid and foolish, they push that through the algorithm and the numbers are through the roof. So I know everything gets set up for the crazy, crazy.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, so I don't even care about the numbers. When I'm doing something that's positive, the numbers are low live. Let me start talking about Jake's and Manasseh stuff or stuff. Yes. Through the roof.
Through the roof.
Because they want, and see, that's the thing. They want me to create the entertainment and drama around the story. Well, you don't get to dictate through your presence and how many numbers and how much money you even get when I'm live. That's going to determine whether I'm going to do something that is going to injure the vision that I have for myself in tomorrow, today. You're not going to do that. I'm never going to make a sacrifice to today just for the moment. I'm not going to do it with my ping. I'm not going to do it with my AMX card. I'm not going to do it with anything today that I'm going to be sorry for tomorrow. Oh, no. That's, you should have called me when I was a little dumber.
That would have been 2022, I think.
That's real funny.
I'm just saying. No, facts. And you after the work. And I love that. After the transformation. And really, that's really being after the hearts of the people. That's really being after the people, actually.
Yeah, I want to help folks. I want to help people in all different kinds, different types and kinds of ways. And I'm doing it. And I'm going to continue.
More damn help today than they ever have needed it. People told the hell up. People need a day at work. So to work. We got work to do. Really,
God, we've been on a long time.
Yeah, so let's get the hell off. I know you got things to do. Mm-hmm. I want to thank you for being here. And I want to make mention that just to back up how much you show up for me and you care for me, you lost your grandmother yesterday and have been spending the bulk of today planning funeral services, being on the phone with relatives, etc.
How we gonna get there? Who going what time?
And yet you carved out now almost 2 hours to be here and to do this shit with me.
Yeah.
So I think that...
Well, you would do it for me?
I absolutely would. But now that you've done this for me, I just want people to now sit in the epicness and the legendariness of that. Because I think that rests its case. That rests its case. So I want to thank you.
But let me say this about you. And y'all see, if you saw that, how he got online and he was weeping and crying, he's very in touch with every piece of how he feel. Even if I felt like that, y'all would never seen it. But... But that consciousness all is very, very wear his heart on the sleeve and feel everything strong. Some stuff I don't even say to him because if I say it, I got to listen to him go off for 5-6 minutes. It has nothing to do with the conversation.
And I'm going to work on that. Too.
Yeah, but it's just fully into this thing. So imagine if you had direct connection with him and y'all have a good relationship. All of that is going, he puts it into his work. He puts it into every last one of his relationship. So this is a good person. He's a good person. And I can't, like if somebody would say, okay, Larry, well, why you deal with conscience? What he gonna, and we've had certain conversations I'm not even gonna say here, but I'm saying, I said, but conscience ain't did nothing to me but be nice.
And I'm never gonna do anything to you but be a ball of love.
Yeah, so I'm like, bro. Y'all ain't talking about that yet. Just yet.
Hold on, they ain't talking about what?
Hey.
They ain't talking about what, doctor? what is it?
Conscious.
And the virus, look, Tyler
gotta have our name. The title gotta have our name.
What you mean it, gotta have my name? What happened?
That's in the end of, and that's in the song. Title gotta have my name for clicks and views, you lame. And that is the reality, the reason why sometimes these people be putting our name and stuff, because they need the click and the view. Yeah.
Okay, so before we wrap, talk to people about the inspiration for the song, because the artwork was legendary. The song is sickening. Like, tell people a little bit about that.
Well, it's Yatan, Y-A-T-A-N, stands for You Ain't Talking About Nothing. And I want everybody to adapt this as a personal anthem, because although I wrote it in response to the low vibratory frequency having side of YouTube, it is something that you can adapt, especially those of you that are always at the center of conversation that is negative, and especially if what they're saying is untrue and is a lie and just a wrong narrative. You need to view it as shit. Because really what I want to say is you ain't talking about shit. But for us, because so everybody can sing the word. So everybody can sing. I wanted to put so much cussing in this song. But I just done a clean version. And I couldn't even release the explicit version. Because it just because I'm an entertainer and a pastor. So I can't do this.
This is an unsaved edit.
Now this is this right here is the saved edit.
I want you to call the explicit version the unsaved edit.
Oh yeah, the
unsaved edit.
yeah, because that's really what I wanted to put out like that. But this is what everybody, if you have been talked about, criticized, scandalized, and called everything but a child of God, then this is a song that you can say and adapt the saying. I'm gonna put t-shirts out with this as well in the spring. You ain't talking about nothing. All of what you saying is just yeah. You ain't doing nothing but yeah. I mean, over and over, just yeah. And so in the song, you hear me in the background, yeah. You know, so it comes out on Friday, which will be late Thursday night. But this is a 16 second clip. And where you can see the words at the bottom, shout out to Blair Monique from BMO Design, who has done a great job with quite a few of my CDs, CD covers, and artwork.
I'm going to be using her ass in the future too.
Yeah, exactly. Now, conscious. You can let me write it, but you can write it yourself. You need to do a track like this when you talking the way that you be talking and your words be rhyming and way you be reading.
Let's write it together. We need to write a diss track to, if we can collab on a diss track.
I don't think you need my help, because the way you write your reads, I don't think it is, but I can help you though. But yes, you need to look at
it. It's coming. Music videos, songs, the whole. I'm about to get up in there.
You need to do, honestly, no lie,
I probably ain't gonna even be doing any more verbal dragging. I'm just gonna put it into
creative music. That's it.
Dragging these hoes.
That's right. So when they stream it, to hear what you're saying about them, they paying you too.
That's hard. This is why this nigga did. You see how this nigga, his brain worked like a cash machine. His brain is a whole cash register. Whole cash register right there.
Yeah, that's period. True. Yeah. No, that's very true. It's well, a gift. But I don't know if you can play it. Can you play that? If you back it up to the
beginning. Can you hear it?
I don't hear anything. Yeah.
You hear it?
We can hear it.
Okay. This is a 16 second clip, y'all are yatting.
That's just a little piece of it. So It comes out on Friday.
Who produced this track? Like, who produced it?
A friend that I've had for several decades was a musician of my church in Fayetteville, North Carolina. And he collaborated with another guy whose name is slipping from me, but his name is Junior Hendley.
Wow.
Fayetteville, North Carolina. I have made a post and I asked people for tracks. Send out some texts, and I got so many. But this one just hit me.
Yeah.
So we've done the paperwork.
This was him. This was he. This track was he. This
yeah.
Is
he.
Yeah.
Of course, I put some other instruments in there. I called some other people because I wanted to make it
I want to add more to it. But the bass track,
it has a lot of dimension. I'm glad you added everything you added to it, because it sounds full.
Yeah, I did. Because it was just the beat. But I wanted to, I wanted to add some more dimension. I wanted some strings. I wanted some drama. I actually have, with the 808, I have a bass player that is actually laying some undertones, some deeper bass undertones, especially during the verse part. You know, so it's well thought out, well produced. The same guy who do my mixing is the same one that Atlantic Records use for every person you can think of on Atlanta, including Cardi B. He's working on this stuff. So he did my mixing and actually recorded my vocals for doing it all. And
great team, like stellar production. This is radio worthy. This is chart worthy.
Yeah, but this is for us. I'm not even gonna push it through the charts. I'm not gonna it's gonna be registered. I'm not gonna put any money behind it and pushing it. It's for me and for you and other content creators and those of you in the chat who have been the subject of people's conversations that are basically just talking straight up shit. You ain't talking about nothing. That's what you can say. You're just yatting.
Because we went on that paperwork now. We went on everybody else's paperwork now. we went on everybody's paperwork. Because if you ain't got that paperwork, you ain't talking about yatting.
You ain't talking about nothing. You yatting. You ain't talking about nothing.
Everybody asking, like, where is this going to drop? Is it going to drop on? Is
everywhere.
On streaming service. Okay.
Look right there to the left. It says Apple Music, Spotify, YouTube, Amazon Music. Tidal and Pandora. Then more than that, it's gonna be everywhere. You
really, I am so excited for this. I'm letting y'all know I'm retiring a Nicki Minaj, so y'all gonna be hearing yatting in the intro until Dr. Reid writes another diss track. Yatting, baby, until episode 2. This was epic. I'm excited. This was amazing.
Great conversation.
I couldn't thank you enough, Doctor. People gonna hold you to us getting into some spiritual things.
It's time now. They don't have to hold me to that.
Well, there is anyway.
Yeah.
But before we tie it up, can you help the folk to race?
Oh, okay. I don't say why people ask me to do this, because I'm a giver. And because I am a giver, there's a contract between me and money everywhere. And so if I ask people to donate, then they're going to donate because my ask is coming from the same measure of love that is in their heart to give. So my love is meeting your love to show love.
Wow.
And conscious, you are a loving, terribly loving person. And what I'm going to ask, and you may say, oh, that's not a lot of money, but I know $8.88 is not a lot of money, but it's made people millionaires. It has. $12 ain't a lot for a Patreon, but it's made people millionaires, made people double their income. It's about your intention when you do it. So this is what I want you to do. And this will not just be a donation. This will be a seed. And let me tell you why. I see a lot of people online talking about, y'all give y'all seed tonight. But what is the seed? What are we growing? And what's the ground? The ground that we're sowing into is love ground. Because Consciouztv is an example of love, deep, deep love.
Okay, doctor.
I'm telling you, but it's like that. It's too much. So it's a lot. And so I want you to think about your pain that you're healing from. And I want you to look at your $8.88 as if it is a seed that you are putting in the dirt to grow the healing that you need in that space of pain in your soul, and love is going to fill it. So I want you to take $8.88. Those three eights, if you understand gematria, it spells out Christ. So whenever you give and donate three eights, you are moving in the love of Jesus Christ. So we're calling this the love seed. Everybody put in the chat the love seed. And it's just an $8.88 love seed that we're planting into Consciouztv, who is a great ground for love. And we are expecting our harvest to be love in that painful space that we're still healing in our soul. I want every last one of you to do, everybody that says that they have, that after you have done it, I want you to let me know in the chat that you have sowed the love seed. Now, this is not just giving money. This is a spiritual act of planting a seed. We know the seed is a love seed. We know the ground. We qualify the ground because Consciouztv is a deeply loving person, and we expect to see the harvest of healing in that space of pain, love filling that space of pain that is in your soul. And it's going to happen. And it's going to begin to happen.
It's already coming through. I'm hearting it up now. It's all coming through.
Yeah. But this is spiritual. I mean, it's what I like to call money magic. Because although the seed is $8.88, we're calling it the love seed and all of that, the natural side is reciprocity. Whenever you give money, you get money. Don't y'all believe what nobody telling you? Now, the problem when it don't happen for folk call is the wrong person, it's the wrong ground. Maybe your intention was fucked up. This is why I'm trying to help you set your intention before you give your $8.88 so that you can get the result of what I'm saying. So you have to give it with that intention so that that be what you get back. So the flip side is the love aspect. That's a spiritual aspect. But the natural side is, if I'm giving $8.88, I'm going to get that money back. I'm going to say in faith with all of the powers that are in my mantle of the prophetic that in 7 days, you're going to get this back over 4 times. Unexpected. What you did not know was coming. Not what you know that's coming, but what you did not know. So you can just understand the power of sowing money and giving money, because the church has seen people be hirelings, be fake and phony, and people just out of their money, out of their home, out of their cars, and the church got the money. But if you follow what I tell you, and somebody else I know is Bishop Bernard Jordan, and you follow what I say, and you really give it in the right energy and really soak in what I'm saying around what this seed is, watch what happens.
Y'all done turned me into a 1,000-year church mother.
I'm going to tell you what's going to happen, Conscious. You in the moment, you be excited. You see the money coming in. Money is what it is. You're going to feel it.
I feel it. Doctor, I want you to hear this word. I feel it deep.
You're going to feel it. Yeah, and it's holy too, Conscious. So you know.
I know, because I feel it. I feel the holiness.
Yeah, it's holy. It's people's money. That is theirs.
Oh my God. Now, would it be unholy to say, McWig and Unhinged, thank you, because you made today's programming a hella successful?
No, I'm not. And this is how come. Now, let me tell you this. Now, you know how I feel about this. We get into about this. This is why these people are employees.
Oh.
And there's no need to really get upset. You just need to feel and spell your name right, because they really are working for free. I'm gonna tell you, I know how much it costs to pay an influencer, to pay somebody to get online in front of their audience and promote your product. So if you're gonna do that free for me, I just need to make sure when the people come to my page to look for me, that they hear something, feel something, say, let me watch that again. That's you working for me.
That part. Yeah. Oh, we got free. Thank you, volunteer contractors. Appreciate you, baby. My God, today, look, I can't. It's so many of y'all. I can't even. I can't even go down. Should I call out the names?
To say thank you, absolutely.
Oh my God,
this people money.
Thank you, LaShawn, Corey, Robin, Brittany, Satara, Faith, Andrea, Kimberly, Tania, Nicole, Kenton, Teresa, Star, Auntie Trisha, Kimberly, Tamikia, Leslie, Courtney, Teresa, Kim, Doe Eyes, Burl Robinson, thank y'all. Sarah H, they keep coming. Thank y'all. God bless y'all. Thank y'all. I love y'all. Mm-hmm. Thank y'all. I appreciate y'all. Doctor,
Conscious gonna be crying later on.
I will be. And I'm going to go live and get an ass something else to load up. Because I told them last night that I said it's my party and I'm gonna cry if I damn want to.
Yeah.
So anytime I'm feeling the spirit, I'm gonna feel it. But if you feel complete, I am complete here.
Yes, you hear what Kimberly said. This is key. It's the spiritual principle of enemies being your footstool.
Kimberly, you better stop.
They help you reach somebody or something or a thing that you could not reach without them.
You better stop it, Kimberly.
This is why I don't be upset. I've learned how to turn my enemies into employees.
Or coin.
Everybody type that. God showed me how to turn my enemies into employees. I mean, because you have to know how to,
wow,
to shift that energy. I mean, because it's this script.
Wow. That part. Well, this was amazing. This was complete. This was everything. I thank you for carving time out for you and I and to come up here and to address this in the way that only the doctor can. You guys heard it first. Friends to the end. Ain't no shame about it. It is what the hell it is.
Yeah.
We're going to run these streets hard, baby, and y'all just going to have to live with it, child. Mm-hmm. I want to go out on yatting, so...
Hey!
Mm-hmm. can we go out on yatting?
You can!
This yatting, y'all. The 29th, dropping on all streaming services. Thank y'all. Subscribe, share, spread the truth, girl. Make the truth, make the receipts, viral, screenshot it all. Throw it up there. We love y'all.